There'll be some new people who have become attached to these movements who will who will no longer be voting for the major parties. So the first truck convoy started in Canada and is still going in Canada. And I started with some genuine truckers who were frustrated about COVID restrictions in Canada. And that has inspired similar COVID-related protests around the world.
This is basically people who have been affected by vaccine mandates and have been limited from various aspects of society, whether it's they're no longer able to participate in the jobs that they were in, whether it's they're not allowed to go to certain hospitality venues. So they're responding to government policies that are basically targeting their non-vaccination status and making life difficult for them. Some within these groups are looking at doing non-violent protest circles, etc. But others, of course, are seeking to, close freeways and blockade places.
And some were wanting to drive a truck, at this place as well. So one had a firearm, illicit firearm with ammunition and plans at this house. So, yeah, we're concerned.
Things that was really clear was that they're having little to no political influence at this point of time. We haven't seen any governments being pushed to make changes to COVID restrictions or to make changes to anything in response to the protests. That is slightly different to Canada, for example, where some of their provincial governments have made changes based in, at least in part, off response to the protests. But we're not seeing that here in Australia. COVID will be a central part of how people vote in this, I think, for both these protesters, and I think for a lot of other people as well. I think there'll be some new people who have become attached to these movements who will no longer be voting for the major parties because of what's happened in COVID.